There have been reports in the last 1 week regarding the work and activities of the Senate Public Accounts Committee. I have said it before, that there are people who would wish to besmirch the integrity of this particular committee because they know that the committee has lined up far-reaching recommendations against them. There are governors who have claimed that the committee has been unfair to them, and I want to challenge them. If they feel that they've been unfairly treated, if they feel that they've been extorted by this committee, the right thing to do, if they believe in integrity, is for them to come to Parliament and report and tell Parliament that on this date, Mr. X met me at place Y at time Z, and this is what transpired. That is the best way for us to deal with corruption, not just in the counties, but corruption in Parliament. I stand firm on the integrity of the committee, and I challenge those who have any allegations of mispropriety that they have an opportunity to bring those allegations before Parliament. It will not be the first time we will be dealing with such allegations. We dealt with them in the Ruaraka report, and it is becoming a trend that every other time that Parliament is about to condemn powerful people, these powerful people play reverse psychology and they accuse Parliament itself of being compromised. Next week, I'll be laying on the table of Parliament 50 reports with far-reaching recommendations, including a recommendation where we have declared a specific governor unfit to hold public office. Corruption fights back, and we see it fighting back in this particular manner.